What's up, my dudes? This is Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U, and today we're going to talk about 11 code terms that may be just confusing the shit out of you. People have been asking me to do some like simple code terms so that while they're reading a code book, they know what the fuck they're talking about. Because in code, we don't use that same language that we use out in the field a lot. That happens a lot. So we hear the term outlet and we think, oh, well, that's a plug. No, not really. Kind of. Let's get into it. Number one, ungrounded conductor. An ungrounded conductor in layman's terms is the hot wire. It's the one that's not touching ground anywhere. Number two, the grounded conductor. The grounded conductor is the neutral. That's the one that is intentionally grounded from the transformer that's up on a pole somewhere. They've taken the center point of that coil of wire. You got a hot on one end, hot on the other end. That's what your two hots are in a 220. The very middle point is the neutral point, and that's where they tap the neutral conductor or the grounded conductor. And they intentionally ground to earth that conductor. That's the grounded conductor, the white one. Number three, equipment grounding conductor. This is the green or bare conductor that we use, that we call the trade name, layman's terms out there, the ground. It's the one that runs to a piece of equipment, gets hooked up to the metal casing of that equipment. That way, if the ungrounded or hot conductor just flops off and hits that the casing of that equipment, it still makes a complete circuit back to the neutral, to the grounded conductor, to trip that circuit. Number four, ground fault. So a ground fault is basically when a ungrounded conductor touches a metal piece of equipment. That is, the equipment is now grounded out, you'll hear. A ground fault, a lot of people say short, this is not a short. A short circuit and a ground fault, two completely different things. So when a hot touches a ground, or when a hot touches a piece of metal equipment, that is a ground fault. Number five, ground fault circuit interrupter. So this is a fancy term for the GFCI receptacles. Like, you'll go into your bathroom and see a GFCI there. They also have breakers that do the exact same thing, so you don't have to have the receptacle, you can have the breaker instead. But it's a breaker that is specifically designed to detect whether or not a ground fault is occurring. And then it breaks the circuit, trips the circuit, and saves lives. Number six, arc fault. So an arc fault is when arcing happens. When arcing happens, it's basically a high power discharge between two things. And when there's an arc between two objects, the characteristics of that circuit change drastically. And you can start heating up the insulation around the conductors, melting them, and then causing a ground fault or a short circuit to happen. Number seven, arc fault circuit interrupter. So just like the GFCI, the ground fault circuit interrupter, there's an arc fault version of the same thing. It's usually a breaker, or it can be a receptacle with the same idea, but the premise is that these devices are able to sense arcs. And a lot of them, if you have a combination arc fault circuit interrupter, it can sense parallel arcs and series arcs, meaning a series arc is between one hot and another hot, like the same circuit. Parallel arc would be like a hot and a neutral. It's arcing between two wires that are, one's the like supply side and one's the return side. Number eight, short circuit. So a short circuit is basically saying power is taking a shortcut. When it's leaving a panel and coming back, when we run wires out to a load, that load is getting in the way and it's purposeful. So when you run wires out to, say, a motor, well, all we're doing is taking the black and the white and we're touching them across that piece of equipment. And we notice nothing happens, nothing blows up, but that motor starts working, it starts spinning. So that is a circuit. Now, a short circuit would be if I were to take those two wires off the motor and touch them together. Now there is just a complete circuit all the way from the source to the source without any kind of resistance in there to stop that massive movement of electrons at one point. So short circuit usually means between two ungrounded or hot conductors, you can have a short circuit. It's basically when you cut the load out of the equation and just touch the wires together, If you have them next to each other and they get nicked and then they touch, that's a short circuit. It generates a shitload of heat at one given time. So it'll pop a breaker if you've got breakers hooked up to them. Otherwise, it'll just start arcing. It'll be like welding between those two things. But not only between two hots or ungrounded conductors, it also happens between ungrounded and grounded, meaning hot and neutral. Number nine on our list is an outlet. So an outlet does not mean a plug, a receptacle. They actually, plug is only used when you're talking about a cord with that little thing in the end that has the prongs that you plug in, that is a plug. So an outlet means that you have created something where you can take current out of it. So we have lighting outlets. That's a box with wires in it where we take current out to a piece of equipment. We have receptacle outlets where it's another box in a wall with wires coming out of it. And we can hook a receptacle up to that and put it in, and we are taking power out and supplying it to a piece of equipment. So outlet does not mean receptacle. A receptacle is a type of outlet, but there are also lighting outlets. Number 10, receptacle, just kind of covered that. But again, a receptacle is specifically something that you take plugs and plug them into. So any cord and plug connected equipment that you would plug into the wall, you're plugging that into a receptacle. There are single receptacles, duplex receptacles, quad receptacles. There's welding receptacles, 50 amp receptacles, 30 amp receptacles. There's all kinds of receptacles. People just call them plugs here in the States, but that's not actually correct. And the last term, number 11, I don't have another finger. Number this many is yoke. So you're gonna see the term yoke, Y-O-K-E, in code. And all that's referring to is the metal part that the receptacle or the switch is mounted to. In this case, you got a switch, right? The switch is this part, the yoke is this part. The thing that the switching mechanism is attached to, it's the frame of the device. That may not seem like an important term to know, but there are things that you have to calculate based off how many receptacles are on one yoke or how many devices are on one yoke. So I hope that helps, guys. That's the 11 terms for today, at least, for code terminology. I'm gonna do more of these videos. There's so many that are so difficult to understand and know what you're talking about. But I hope that helps you when you're studying for your test, trying to figure out what the hell these terms mean. Love you, people. See you in the next one.